Hello and greetings from Iceland. After a quiet week, Mother Earth decided to tease us with earthquakes, and many of them got us wondering what was underlying. And I'm starting with the volcano Katla. We know about this trend there. The seismic activity increases in the fall after the summer has melted some of the ice above the caldera and relieved some of the pressure. And this autumn, Katla has actually been behaving quite well, or until now, when she got naughty with a magnitude 4.5 at a very little depth, almost at the surface. And such earthquakes, they are actually not rare. So the depth of those earthquakes wasn't enough reason to turn on the alarms that we actually have all around this very dangerous volcano. And our main concern is of course the fact that Katla is long overdue. When we look at history, the interval between eruptions is 50-60 years, and the last eruption was in 1918, over 100 years ago. So it's just impossible to say what this sleeping giant has in store for us. And every time Katla sneezes, it makes it to the news. And it also makes the Civil Protection Agency ready to push the button to evacuate the complete region. And this is a village Vík, that is one of the potential flood paths, but it is however more likely that the village would be hit with a tsunami that would be generated from a flash flood coming down from the glacier and hitting the sea east of town. So this location is suspect number one when Katla erupts full force, although there are numerous other scenarios possible. And as always, when we see earthquakes in Katla, I tend to get questions in the comment section. So I'm going to leave a link for one of the tools that our experts use, or the river monitors. Increased electrical conductivity from volcanic material is one of the tools to find out what is going on, and the water level, of course. So it's a good idea to have this link nearby if things get shaky. And although this earthquake swarm isn't fully over yet, it looks as it might be the case soon. And I'm still not sure if my generation will live to see the first Katla eruption since 1918. But I do however suspect that it will be the case. But if it's going to be this year, or next year, or 10 years, it's just impossible to say. So let's move to the Reykjanes Peninsula. We can see a little uptick in seismic activity by Grindavík, and the next eruption could technically start any day now, since there is enough magma in the magma chamber already to get things going. I do however expect to see way more earthquakes before this starts, or when the magma chamber starts to pressure us, seriously, judging from the last eruptions. So as for the timing, I would say at least 10-15 days more, even longer. So we will just have to wait. And the biggest news of the day might be the seismic activity by Lake Klevarvatn. That is actually on another level now. And the scientists have not explained the situation there, not yet. And it's not an easy task because this is not about ground uplift, indicating magma on the move. It's the other way around. The ground is subsiding fast, and it has been doing so for the last 3-4 months. Like the monitor in the valley, Móhálsvadalur is showing 5 centimeters. And the thing is that there are just so many elements at this location. First, we have the plate boundaries running along the peninsula, roughly outlined from the southwest, northeast trending volcanic ridges and faults. And then we have a set of north-south trending transcurrent faults that are responsible for the largest earthquakes on the peninsula. and it seems to be just about where the growing earthquakes form is by Klefarvatn, forming this north-south lineup, not far away from this same fault. But I'm not saying that we can blame it on that. And when we look at the wider picture and follow the plate boundaries eastward, the area between Lake Klefarvatn and Hengill Volcano has been very shaky lately, especially around the north-south trending fault south of Reykjavik that generates a magnitude 6 plus earthquake every 50 years. And there was an official warning issued just recently, and it looks to me as that warning is still very valid. And looking at history, only 5 years before the magnitude 6 plus earthquake in 1929, we got hit with a magnitude 5 plus close to the earthquake location at Lake Klefarvatn. So it occurred to me, are we looking at a tectonic event and the Klefarvatn fault will snap first before the fault closer to Reykjavik, or a similar event as we saw in 1924. And although that earthquake by Klefarvatn wasn't huge, it was quite dramatic. As a bonus feature, we got a steam explosion that left us with a new boiling mud pool that entertained the local farmers for years, more than any theater in the city could do. It was shooting up mud, and according to local news back then, it was so spectacular that tickets for such a show would cost more than $100 today. But that mud pool did, however, develop into a more friendly and dull hot spring called Engjakver. And tourists can access that hot spring from the car park by the explosion crater Grindavík. And we have yet another explosion crater just beside it. So as for tectonic elements and geological features, this area has it all. And this area has also experienced episodes of ground inflation and deflation. That has been going on for years, and the more recent episodes started with ground uplift between 2007 and 2009. That was about 3 centimeters, and the ground subsided between 2009 and 2010. And between 2011 and 12, there was uplift of over 7 centimeters. And the ground subsided again between 2012 and 2015. And when the first earthquake started to indicate that something was not as it should be by Grindavík in 2020, ground uplift was also starting by Krýsuvik, but it was never anything close to what was going on by Grindavík. And I didn't make the earthquakes by Klefarvatn into a topic for my channel until after the so-called Little Hrútur eruption in 2023. That is when things got a bit complicated. So I've been mentioning this region from time to time, especially since the Met Office kept on saying that these earthquakes were triggered from the constantly inflating and deflating magma chamber by Grindavík. But I never bought into that. And today, we do not only have increased seismic activity, we see the earthquakes also pushed to the north through the valley Móhálsadalur. And by the way, I have a new video online there I'm driving through that valley, and I recommend it. And then we see the earthquakes run across the next volcanic ridge almost all the way to the mountain Keilir. And those who have been with me here on the channel for long enough, they might remember that the mountain Keilir was the center of attention for a long time, or before the first three eruptions started, since the magma dike that fed many of those eruptions was making its way up literally under Keilir. And with this activity moving there, we have almost closed a kind of circle. But the ground is, however, subsiding, and what that means is hard to say. So my first guess is that this is primarily a tectonic event. But given how powerful and explosive geothermal area is under there, we can't rule out some changes in the dynamics there. Earthquakes can easily mess up the geothermal plumbing system there, making things even more complicated. So I'm very curious to see what our scientists come up with, if they will comment on this soon, and I'm not sure until we get a even larger earthquake there. But this location by the lake has always worked as a magnet for me. There is just something about this place. And one of the mysteries is the alleged old caldera under the lake. And there is in general lack of good information about this location, which is not good due to the proximity to the capital region. I am going to say that this is tectonic and perhaps a part of the build-up to the next big earthquake on the peninsula. So that is my uneducated guess. And as for the next eruption, I am going to be close by with a drone. And I got actually a bit worried yesterday when it started snowing and snowing a lot. And although I have already bought studded tires, they are still in the back of my car. So I was thinking if the eruption would start now, I would first have to sit for hours at the long line in front of the tire shop. And I'm in no mood for that now. And lately I've been concentrating on photo and video processing. And since the new drone has a camera that is outstanding in still photo quality as well, I have been spending enormous time in Photoshop. It's the best way to get to know the camera. So although I haven't been uploading much, this has been huge work for me. And a bit of a learning curve as well. So I will be turning back to production again to my usual upload schedule. And with that, I'm sending you best regards from the volcano island, Iceland.